We continue our reading of From the Heart, a daily devotional by author Ellen G. White. Today's reading, April 30. The Pharisee and the Publican. God, I thank you that I am not like other men, or even as this tax collector. Luke 18:11. Read Luke 18:9 to 14. Reading from the New King James Version. Also, he spoke this parable to some who trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One, a Pharisee, and the other, a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank you that I am not like other men, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give tithe of all that I possess. And the tax collector, standing afar off, would not so much as raise his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast, saying, God be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. We continue our reading. Both these men are represented as resorting to the same place for prayer. Both came to meet with God. But what a contrast there was between them. One was full of self-praise. He looked it, he walked it, he prayed it. The other realized fully his own nothingness. The Pharisee was looked upon as righteous before God, and thus he was in his own estimation. The publican, in his humility, looked upon himself as having no claim to the mercy or approval of God. The publican would not so much as lift his eyes to heaven, but smote upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. The searcher of hearts looked down upon both men, and he discerned the value of each prayer. He looks not on the outward appearance. He judges not as human judges. He does not value us according to our rank, our talent, education, or position. He saw that the Pharisee was full of self-importance and self-righteousness, and the record was made against his name, weighed in the balances, and found wanting. The majesty of heaven humbled himself from the highest authority, from the position of one equal with God, to the lowest place, that of a servant. His trade was that of a carpenter, and he labored with his hands to do his part in sustaining the family. His humility did not consist in a low estimate of his own character and qualifications, but in humbling himself to fallen humanity in order to raise them with him to a higher life. That person is nearest God and is the most honored of him who has the least self-importance and self-righteousness, the least trust and confidence in self, who waits on God in humble, trusting faith. Pride and self-importance, when compared with humility and lowliness, are indeed weakness. It was our Savior's gentleness, his plain, unassuming manner, that made him a conqueror of hearts. God looks down from heaven with pleasure on the trusting, believing ones who have a full sense of their dependence on Him. To such He delights to give when they ask Him. He satisfieth the longing soul and filleth the hungry soul with goodness. Signs of the Times, October 21, 1897. This concludes our reading today of From the Heart. No matter what our situation is, Jesus will be with us through it all.
I had so many tears and sorrows, had questions for tomorrow. There've been times I didn't know right from wrong, but in every situation God gave me trusted consolation, and He only gave me trials to make me strong. How would I know but faith in God?